Hi everybody, it is I, Christopher. I'm here to read Psalm 13. First, I want to compel you to believe in Jesus Christ. Every one of us is guilty before God because of our sin. Every one of us has sinned against God. God is holy and perfect and sinless, and we are flawed humans, born in sin, dead in our trespasses and sins, and we can't do anything that would make us acceptable before God. He does call us to repent from our sins and believe in Him and follow Him, but doing that doesn't make us righteous before God. Our righteousness is a gift from Jesus Christ. It's a gift from God through the baptism of the Holy Spirit and the being born again, being made new, and being made no longer sinners, but being made saints. You enter into the kingdom of God by being born again by the Spirit of God. And Jesus made the way for that to be possible by coming to the earth in the flesh of man. He fulfilled hundreds of prophecies about himself in the scriptures. When he appeared on the earth 2,000 years ago, he was first came through a virgin birth. The Holy Spirit caused Mary, his mother, to be pregnant with him, the Word of God, who was in the beginning, who was with God and who was God. And the Word became flesh. And then he was born as a man, born as a son, a child, who was fully human and fully God. And he grew in grace of God and grace with men. And he never sinned. He obeyed his parents, he obeyed God the Father, and he walked as a man in full communion with the Father in heaven. And then when the time was right for him to go out and proclaim who he was and proclaim the gospel, the gospel of the kingdom, that in the Old Testament it was prophesied that a king was going to come and he was going to have an undying kingdom that will never end, that he came through the lineage of David, so he was in a sense the son of David. He was before Abraham was. He said that I am before Abraham was. I am. He said that he was the I am. He was Jehovah. He was one with the Father, and he was the one who would send the Holy Spirit, who would baptize in the Holy Spirit, and that he would the Spirit that we receive would be the Spirit of our Father in heaven, and that he would be the Spirit of Christ, and the Spirit of God, and the Father was in heaven, and Jesus said that I and the Father are one. Yeah, so Jesus was fully man and fully God, and he walked the earth, and he never sinned, and he went out preaching the gospel of the kingdom, saying that he was the promised king, and he was the Son of God, and that if you believe in him, you would be saved. He called people to repent, to turn from their sins, and to believe in him and be saved. Then he delivered himself up as a guilty man, though he was perfect and innocent. He fulfilled the law of God. He never sinned. And then he was delivered up by the Jews to the Romans. They sentenced him to death. First they beat him and mocked him and whipped him and scourged him, had his flesh torn off his body. And then he was nailed to a cross by his hands and feet, where he died. And then he was pierced in his side and outflowed blood and water. Then he was buried in a grave, and he remained there for 3 days. Then he resurrected from the dead. He showed himself to all his followers and to over 500 people at one time. Witnesses that God chose beforehand that they should witness that he was on the earth. Then he told his disciples to wait in Jerusalem for the promise of the Father. God promised to pour out his Spirit upon all flesh, that he would give them a new heart, and that he would write his laws in their heart. And then he ascended back to heaven. He levitated back into heaven. The disciples witnessed him go up, and then they waited in Jerusalem for the promise of the Father. The Holy Spirit was poured out 10 days later on the day of Pentecost, and they went out preaching the gospel with power. Jesus said that you would receive the Holy Spirit and you would receive power to be witnesses to me in Jerusalem, Judea, and into all the earth. The disciples went out proclaiming the gospel with power, signs, wonders, and they raised up other disciples and taught them to obey all things that Jesus taught them to obey. And those disciples went out and made disciples and taught them to obey all that Jesus taught the first disciples to obey. And it's been ongoing since 2,000 years ago when Jesus first appeared on the earth in the flesh of man. And he's going to come back again someday. And when he comes back, he's bringing the wrath of God against all who did not believe in him and receive the forgiveness of sins that was provided by his death and resurrection. So he's going to bring wrath upon the earth. It's going to be a time of great tribulation, and there is going to be a rising up of Satan because he knows his time is short, and it will be great trials and tribulation on the earth. Then Jesus will appear in heaven. The saints will be resurrected. Those who are on the earth who are still alive, they will ascend to heaven and be with him in the clouds. Then the wrath of God will be poured out upon the earth and upon all the remaining people who will not repent for their sins. After all these great plagues are poured out upon them, they still will not repent. And then Jesus will set his feet upon the earth, and the saints of God will come with him, riding on horses, clothed in white robes, because they were made righteous because of the blood of Jesus, because they believed in him and they were born new by his Spirit. So if you believe in Jesus, you would become righteous by the gift of God. You would no longer be known as sinners, but you would then be known as the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. You would be accepted by God. You would have peace with God through faith in Jesus Christ. You would have the grace of God to walk as a child of God, to obey him, to follow him, and to turn away from your sins. And that if you did still sin after that all that happened, you would still have an advocate in heaven who intercedes on our behalf. Because of his shed blood, it makes us clean. He bore our sickness and our disease on his body and our sin on his body, so that we don't have to accept the judgment and the works of the devil, the sickness and disease he brings upon people. Jesus made a way for us to be forgiven. He made a way for us to be healed and made whole and delivered. And if you put your trust and faith in him, you can have all of that. And then when you die, you would go to heaven to be with him in the spirit. And then you would be resurrected one day and have the same kind of body that he had. And if you do not believe in him, then you will die in your sins. Jesus said that if you do not believe that I am he, you would die in your sins. And when you die in your sins, you will have to pay for those sins. You did not have a substitute to pay for your sins because you didn't put that trust in Jesus. And your spirit is eternal. It will exist forever. And when it's cast into hell, because you did not have that atonement, that substitute for you to take the wrath of God for you against sin, you would have to go to hell for yourself. And then one day you will be resurrected too, and then judged according to the things that you did on the earth in the flesh. And then you will be cast into the same place that Satan and the fallen angels are cast, and that's a lake of fire. So Jesus made the way for us to have eternal life through faith in him, and we would live forever on a paradise, a new heaven and a new earth, where there will be no more tears, there will be no more pain, no more sin, no more suffering. It will just be us with God face to face, forever with him, in glorified bodies that do not corrupt, that do not face death, that will not have pain or sickness or disease or sin or Satan or any of the corruption that is in the world now. It will be a place of righteousness that is beautiful and lovely and good, and it'll be forever. Eternal life. Believe in Jesus and receive it. So I'm going to read Psalm chapter 13. How long, O Lord? Well, first, the title. I like to read the title here in my my Bible version. So it says, Trust in the Salvation of the Lord, Psalm chapter 13. To the chief musician, a psalm of David. How long, O Lord, will you forget me forever? How long will you hide your face from me? How long shall I take counsel in my soul, having sorrow in my heart daily? How long will my enemy be exalted over me? Consider and hear me, O Lord my God. Enlighten my eyes, lest I sleep the sleep of death. Lest my enemy say, I have prevailed against him. Lest those who trouble me rejoice when I am moved. But I have trusted in your mercy. My heart shall rejoice in your salvation. I will sing to the Lord because he has dealt bountifully with me. Amen. David had a lot of sorrow. And we do too. This life is difficult and hard. Even after you become born again and saved by Jesus, it is still a struggle a lot of times. But if we put our trust in him, he will be our deliverer, our healer, our hope. He will come through for us if we put our trust in him. And if you have sickness or disease or pain in your body, I just want to speak to that right now. By faith in the name and the authority in the name of Jesus Christ, that he bore our sickness and pain on his body so that you don't have to. So I command your body be made healed, be made whole, be free right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I speak to that disease. I command it to go. Be delivered now from this person. Leave this person now. Unclean spirit, go from this person right now in the name of Jesus. Work of the devil, be stopped now in Jesus' name. Life to you, to your flesh, to your bones, to your tissues, to your cells, to your thinking, that your mind would come into peace and you would have clear thinking, clear peace and joy and life. Life and life in abundance in the name of Jesus Christ to you by the power of the Holy Spirit and in the authority and faith in the name of Jesus right now to you. Amen. So until next time, if you'd like to reach out, go to lovesflame.com and the contact us tab. There's different ways you can reach me. There's also like social media links on that website. So until next time, grace, peace, and love in Jesus Christ. Okay, bye.